Hello, Penn High School, and welcome back to PNN. I'm your reporter, Ben Burns.
And I'm Madisyn Runbarger. Today is Friday, December 17th, the last day before winter break.
Before Thanksgiving break let out, a student here at Penn had been handed a white privilege card. The card is white and looks typical to your normal credit card, and with a WP on the corner. Principal Gallagher sent out an email encouraging students to turn in these cards if found or seen, and that this does not reflect our Take 3 motto. In an interview with ABC 57, Gallagher states that the situation is currently being investigated.
The PHM School Board of Trustees recently appointed two new members. James Turnwald is filling seat number one left vacant by Mrs. J. Galloway and will remain on the seat until the end of 2022. Mr. Ryan McCullough is filling seat number two, which was previously filled by Mr. Jamie Woods, and his term will last until 2024. They were chosen out of eight applicants and took their oath on Monday, December 13th. Superintendent Dr. Thacker was excited to welcome the new members.
The Community Foundation of St. Joseph County announces the recipients for the class of 2022. The scholarship pays full tuition for any public university in Indiana. The foundation awards a scholarship to four people, and this year they were all from Penn. Lilly Endowment Community Scholars are known for community involvement, academic achievement, character, and leadership. The scholarships have been offered to Hala Ansari, Manal Butch, Salem Fitwe, and Luca Najim.
Congratulations, guys. Right now, our blood banks are in desperate need of blood donations. If you are interested in donating, go to redcross.org and put in your zip code to find the blood bank closest to you. The blood bank closest to Penn is the South Bend Medical Foundation, which is located on Edison Road and is open from 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. on weekdays and 7:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. on Saturdays. You have to be at least 16 to donate and weigh 110 pounds.
Hey, Molly, I heard there's a lot going around Penn recently.
Yes, Madisyn, there is so much to participate and to be a part of here at Penn High School. Hi, I'm Molly Knight, and I'll be bringing you your social calendar for this week. The Penn Republican Club will be meeting after winter break on Thursday, January 6th after school in room 173. If you are interested in joining, contact Mr. Schetzel at dschetzel@phm.k12.in.us. The wait for the Fall Spectrum magazine is almost over. If you're interested in reading some of your classmates' poetry and short stories or seeing their works of art, the Spectrum Committee is planning on having them available after break the first weeks in the bookstore for $5. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Molly. Hey, Madisyn, did you hear that the Cookie Crumble is opening?
Yes, I'm so excited because it's going to be right by my house on the south side of South Bend. So the company is really cool, actually. They rotate their flavors on a weekly basis, so it's kind of different every week. And the flavors will be available for curbside pickup, delivery, and takeout. It'll open at the Radio Shack space in Erskine Village next to Starbucks at 1290 East Ireland Road. And an opening date has not been set yet, but fingers crossed it's soon.
PHM just released the 2022-2023 district calendar. It includes days off, fall and winter break, and the dreaded first day of school. For all the dates included, go to phmschools.org.
Hey, Harley, I heard that Penn winter sports teams have been doing great this year.
That's right, Madisyn. The winter Penn sports teams have been doing fantastic. Hello, Penn sports fans. I'm Harley Kent, bringing your sports for this week. To get started, the boys basketball team went out last Saturday and beat Crown Point. The final score was 52-48. Marcus Burton led the Kingsmen with a team high of 16 points and 9 assists. It was closed most of the game, but the Kingsmen had a run in the fourth quarter, 4-11, which helped them get a win. The Penn Girls basketball team creamed Maryville on December 11th, 52-35. Freshman Jessa Choi led with 13 points. Jada Patton put up 10. Anna Taylor puts up 8. And Lauren Walsh scored 7. The boys swim and dive team placed first in the Munster relay with a score of 146 against South Bend Riley and Lake Central's 130 score. The team won their events with the 200 medley relay, 400 backstroke relay, 850 freestyle relay, and 400 medley relay, putting them over the top. On Saturday, December 1st, this girls' swim team placed first at the Munster's relay with a score of 172, Crown Point followed with 102 points, with Valparaiso on their tail with 96 points. The Kingsmen won in many events, including the 800 medley relay, 400 backstroke and backstroke relays, the 800 medley, 200 relay, and the 400 medley and butterfly relay. The boys' Penn wrestling claimed team title of Elkhart's Jim Nicholson Invitational and also went to LaPorte Invitational. The girls' wrestling placed first at LeBron Invitational. Mackenzie Nozance placed first. Maddie Hatzelton and Emma Batten placed second. Sealish Nuji, Morgan Medizowski, Mia Santel, Miley Perkins were all third, while Alex Johnson and Haley Sales came in fourth. On December 11th, the Penn hockey team destroyed Lake Central with a score of 6-1. They also played Columbus on the same day and still got a good victory, coming in at 3-1. And to the top it off, they also played another game the day after on the 12th against Crown Point. Penn got an outstanding victory, coming in at 4-0. Since Friday's hockey game is senior night, they'll be hosting the teddy bear toss. Be sure to bring a stuffed bear to throw out onto the ice to donate. That's all we have for sports. Have a great winter break. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Harley. I'll remember to bring my stuffed teddy bear to the hockey game.
That looks like all we have for this week, Penn. I hope you have a great winter break, and make sure to follow us on social media at Penn News Network.
Hey, Madisyn, did we walk out of the same closet today?
You know, Ben, I really think this happened by accident. I'd hope we didn't walk out of the same closet, because I don't think we live together.
Oh, that is true. Okay. But it would be pretty cool, though.
I guess.
For many years here at PNN, we have had a great teacher who has taught us a variety of things, not only about broadcasting and journalism, but how to be the best versions of ourselves. Mr. McNulty is about to celebrate a big day, his birthday. We would like to take this time to thank him for everything he has done for us here at PNN. Whether it is through the constructive criticism about the shows, or helping us walk through how to operate a camera, to even the bad puns he uses. He is always there to guide us. For that, we want to thank you. Thank you for everything you do for us, and happy birthday from your students here in PNN.